Today is the day we're gonna leave Turkey. Woohoo! Bye bye Turkey!
Bye bye Turkey!
So we're starting the sail with a distress call.
Do you need help with a tender? We are at anchor. I can send you my tender in 5-10 minutes.
I am Rihanna.
And I am Sherman.
And this is our son Benjamin.
2020 has been a year of adventures and challenges.
We drove all the way from Amsterdam to Didim, Turkey to get to our sailing home.
We did a total refit and now we can finally start sailing around the world while setting up and expanding our businesses.
Join our adventures and welcome on board.
So good morning.
So we'd like to introduce you to our newest family member.
Yes, his name is Gunther.
Gunther. So we left the surf dude Benjamin behind and we got this
Gunther back.
And we actually
we don't like it.
No, we missed the long hair.
No, I went to the hairdresser here in Fethiye. Oh, and he asked me, or I showed him, this is what we want. I just want to cut him the hair a little bit because it was getting too long and
we were not allowed to brush it anymore. It was a real struggle.
Yeah, so we thought, okay, let's go to the hairdresser and to cut it a bit. Before I could do anything, this guy, he cut it like this, and then I saw it and I was, oh no.
Nee, niet op de lens. Hier.
So I'm tightening the sea rail before we put the netting. So we have a good grip. And for the longer crossings we put some safety guards as well on the deck. So yeah, this is really preparing the crossing.
So what did you create?
We found it very hard to put the wire between because it's got curled up right away. So we're now testing with our self-made stick. It's like the principle of fishing thread. It's always around a cloth. I don't know how you call it.
I think it's gonna work. And?
Yeah, much better, right?
Good morning! Today is the day we're gonna leave Turkey! Woohoo!
Marina, Etje Marina, this is setting up perfect sense.
One quick stop at the marina, filling the water tanks, and then we're off to go to Malta. Karen's trying to call the marina.
Etje Marina, Etje Marina, this is setting up perfect sense. Over.
So we're starting the sail with a distress call. There is a motor yacht with fire and two people on board, but we just heard they're gonna send a fast tender to them. So they control the fire, but it's always scary when fellow boaters are in need of help. So it's good to listen and what's happening. We are heading towards them, but we can't go any faster than this.
These guys are over here, so we are heading towards them.
So first meal.
Yes, 12 sailing. That's pretty good, but we don't have a lot of waves yet. We're healing over a little bit, so.
Are you excited?
Yes, I'm feeling so tremendously happy that we're finally setting sail. This took so long.
What?
We're almost a year in Turkey.
Yeah. I'm reading a book about a Dutch couple, and they are sailing around the world many times, and they just started in their book, of course, with a trip 6,500 nautical miles from down Patagonia up to the Azores. So our 700 nautical miles is not that brave yet, but
it is the longest crossing we have done.
It's so far.
It's gonna be the longest crossing we have done so far, yeah. saw our first longer crossing as a family, finally. It was very special to leave Turkey. Also a little bit difficult. Gerben had some abandoning issues.
I always have abandoning issues when we are for a longer period somewhere. I kind of feel familiar with it, and I love the country and the people. So yeah, when we hoist the sails, then it's gone.
Well, after an hour.
After an hour, yeah, that's right. That's right. Yes. No. So we left Göcek, Turkey, and we will head to Malta, or we are heading Malta. And it's a journey. If you go in a straight line, it's 720 nautical miles. And we're gonna cross Greece because we are not allowed to check in into Greece. Because there is a hard border between Turkey and Greece, and because we are coming from Turkey, we are not allowed to check into Greece.
No, and this is quite a long time already, and they were mentioning that it would open up, so we delayed our crossings to Malta for several weeks because we would love to sail through Greece, but it wasn't allowed.
Yeah.
And now we are allowed to transit, so that is good, so we can stop if we would like to for a day or a night.
We can transit, we can fuel and restock groceries if necessary, and we can continue. So yesterday we started, and we started at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and now it's 6 o'clock, and we made already roughly 140 nautical miles, only by sail, really hammering down. So we had a beautiful sail this last night.
And we're definitely those 24 hours of everything put into one. We had rough winds, rough seas. We had beautiful seas like we're experiencing right now. We had some trouble, of course, with the boat.
Yeah.
There's always something going on, but in the end, everything worked out okay.
Yeah.
And you did the night shift, and I was awake actually with Benjamin because we had the rough sail during the night, so nobody really slept pretty good. So it was really that love-hate situation within those 24 hours. And it was very difficult for me because the first part of the 24 hours we had the rough sail, and now we have the beautiful sail. So the first couple of hours I was thinking, oh my God, why did I like this? Why are we doing this? And I remember this also from earlier that we were sailing, that there are those moments that you definitely just want to quit and say, okay, this is just taking too much energy, it's too much
because
that's sailing.
Yes, it's with Benjamin, and we had to prepare everything, so we are fully fueled, stocked, fully prepared. But I forgot one thing. I'm fixing the aft toilet and I didn't finish it, so I closed the sea cocks. I forgot to close the tubes as well, the hoses. So yeah, last night we had a lot of water, salt water in the boat. No, we didn't film it because we really had to pump it out, and Jana found where it was coming from, and I think it was in total it galley flooded with water. So we started pumping, and
We found the leak. Finding the leak and seeing if the pumps could handle it easily, so no stress.
No.
Found the leakage, fixed it. Yeah.
So we are now at Karpathos. We passed Karpathos and we want to cross towards Crete, but the wind isn't favorable. So we decided to just drop anchor in a bay, so I can sleep a little bit for a couple of hours. I think at tonight at around 11-12 we have favorable winds and we can cross towards Crete. And then in the coming weeks we have western wind, so it's gonna be a challenge. Yeah, this afternoon I told Rihanna, I said, okay, can you imagine that we're gonna sail around the world like this?
Yeah, I said yes, but if you asked me this 8 hours ago, I said no.
No, yeah. So we have to get into the rhythm again.
But that's also the things in life. If you want the beautiful things, you have to go through those bad
those stages
moments as well.
It's
part of having a good life.
Yeah. Thank you.
place to anchor for a couple of hours probably. Look at the colors with the sunset. We can't see the sunset, but we can see all the amazing colors. And we can hear the bells of the goats that are walking around here. And there is some kind of teepee over there, and there is a road, so there is something happening here. But just look at all the nature here. Here is more like sandy. But on that side, when we came in, so impressive, all the rocks with the lines in it. So what we're doing right now is sailing around a little bit to see what the depth is everywhere. And there should be sand patches here, which we're looking for, because then the anchor can have a good hold. And we don't want to sit stuck in rocks.
Good morning. We decided to stay here for the night and not gonna sail, because to take out the last water we had from the leakage in the galley, we had a lot of water, and now in the engine room, that's the after the bilge, that's the lowest point. I think after that we're gonna need to swim.
Mama's shoes. Thank you. Where are daddy's shoes?
Up there.
No, there are your shoes. Where are daddy's shoes? Daddy's shoes. Those?
That.
Yeah. Yeah.
Beautiful with those really weird fishermen.
Sheds.
Aren't sheds, it's like tipis.
Tipis, fishermen tipis.
Yeah, so now we're gonna just do a tour with the dinghy, just explore some caves we saw, and then it's ready to set sail again.
Yeah, going to Crete.
Yeah, and we're very happy that we're allowed to stop and drop anchor, because then we just can rest for a few hours or a night, and then we can just go again. Ben! Mountains, those cliffs are really, really, really high. You feel so small here. Thank you.
Yeah, we just left Kassos and we are on our way to Crete. We have 9 up to 10 knots of wind. We make a speed of 1.7 knots, so it's really slow sailing. But it's sailing, we don't use the engine. And it looks like this. Hello.
Hello.
Chilling around?
Yes. Reading a book, Benjamin watching a movie.
Okay. Hello. So now finally the time to really adjust the sail and to trim the sails, and yeah, we're very happy with the new sail setup. So we can trim the Genoa and the main. And I really like doing it when we have 15 knots of wind, open sea, and Benjamin is calm and relaxed. Yeah, we are really improving. And now I improved 0.6 knots of speed just by adjusting the main, and I didn't adjust the Genoa yet. So let's see how far we can push it. Yes, it's beautiful here. It's beautiful to be back in on Greek waters.
We're now at the northern part of Crete,